So just take the quick revision of yesterday's lecture that we have started with the transmission media. The transmission media can be guided or unguided. Guided means the wire communication, unguided means the wireless communication. So in case of the guided or wire communication, we have the three types of cable: twisted pair, coaxial cable, and fiber optic cable. In case of the unguided media, we have the three types of waves. That is radio wave, microwave, and infrared. All three have the different frequencies. First, we have started with the twisted pair cable, in which we can say that there are two types of conductors. One is used to take the signal, other is work as a ground reference. So the twisted pair cables can be of two types. It can be UTP, that is the unshielded twisted pair, and it can be STP, that is the shielded twisted pair. Then the UTP connectors are RJ45, so that practical we have seen in our lab. The application of these twisted pair cables in the voice and data channels. So for example, the telephone lines or the local area networks such as the 10 base T and 100 base T. Okay, so in which we can get a speed up to 10 Mbps or 100 Mbps, we are using the twisted pair cables. The performance of frequency versus attenuation that we have seen, that after the 1000 kilohertz, we can see that there is a sudden increase in the attenuation. Okay, if the cable of 18 gauge or 22 gauge or 24 gauge or 26 gauge, that after the 1000 kilohertz, there is a sudden increase in the attenuation. So we can say that attenuation means loss of energy. So these three criteria we have seen, that attenuation, distortion, and noise. So attenuation means loss of energy, that how much energy will lost during the transmission. So the unit of this attenuation is decibel per kilometer. So you can see that after the 1000 kilohertz frequency, there is a sudden increase in the attenuation. So we require the amplifier, or we require the, we can say, repeater to again regain the energy. Applications. Okay, that we have seen. Then we have the coaxial cable. Coaxial cable is made of the two types of conductor: inner conductor and the outer conductor or shield. Okay, so inner conductors are used to pass the signal, while the outer conductor is used as the ground reference, and both are separated by the insulator, and everything is covered by the plastic cover. The categories of coaxial cable are RJ59, 58, and RJ11. RJ59 is majorly used in the cable TV, while RJ58 is used in the thin Ethernet and RJ11 in the thick Ethernet. Various types of connectors, these are known as the BNC connector. So these BNC connectors are used in the cable TV. This BNCT is to connect, you can say that there are two ends, one device with another device in the network. And this BNC terminator is used to stop the reflection of the signals. So these are installed at the end of the cable, and the ground wire are installed at the end. So this can use to stop the reflection of the signal. The performance of this coaxial cable is says that after the 15 to 100 megahertz, there is a huge increase of the attenuation. So we require the frequent repeater or the amplifier after the 50 kilohertz, or we can say that we require the frequent amplifiers or repeater at the various places. Okay. The applications are previously in analog telephone networks, where a single coaxial network could carry the 10,000 channels. Okay. So previously in the analog telephone network, we are using this coaxial cable. Later in the digital telephone network, where a single coaxial cable could carry digital data up to 600 Mbps. So majorly it is used for the cable TV network and traditional Ethernet LAN. So third category is fiber optic cable. So it is made of glass or plastic, and as you know that it transmits a signal in form of the lights. So there are some principles of this light. Okay, based on that, these fiber optics are working. So if there are two mediums, one is more dense and another one is less dense, then you say that when the incident angle is less than critical angle, then we have the refraction. when the incident angle equal to critical angle, then also we have the refraction, but in the surface, or we can say in the surface direction. While incident angle is greater than critical angle, then we have the reflection. So on this third principle, the fiber optic cables are working. You can see here that we have the two medium, one is core and one is the cladding. The density of core and cladding are different. Okay, always the cladding density is always less than the core density. So whenever your signal enters into the core, we can say there is a reflection, and by that way it will pass through the medium, and finally it is received by the receiver. The type of the propagations into the core. So based on that, we can have a different type of propagation mode. One is the multimode and single mode. Multimode can be again classified as step index and gridded index. So what happened in the multimode step index fiber? So as the name suggests that multimode. Okay, so the signals moves in the multiple modes, and step index means there is a sudden change in the signal. So you can see here that in the figure, the signals are moving like a zigzag signal. Okay, so the reason behind this signal is there is a constant density of the core. Okay, so we can say that your fiber optic cable is made of core and cladding. So in multimode step index fiber, there is a constant density of the core center to the edge. So we can say that the density of the core will remain constant from center to the edge. Apne center thi edge baju jaiye tyan sudhi ma fiber ni je density che the same rahe. Okay, that means we can say that when your signals come to the edges, there is a sudden change in the density. Okay, there is a sudden change in the density. So that's why we can say that there is a sudden change in the signal. So by that way, it is moving like the zigzag way. Okay. Then we have the multimode gridded index fiber. So in such type of fiber, the density of the core are decreasing from center to the edge. Okay. The core ni density chhe, it is not a constant, but center to edge baju jaiye tyam dhime dhime ghatti jai. Okay. So here we can say that the shape of the signals is like our analog signals. Okay, the shape of the signal is like the analog signal. The reason is the density of the core is going to be decreased from center to the edge. Center to edge baju jaiye tem apni density ghatti jaye. That's why there is no sudden change, but we can say there is a circular change. So we can say that the signal is like a analog signals. Okay. Then we have the single mode. In case of the single mode, the fiber itself is manufactured with a much smaller diameter than that of multimode fiber, and with substantially lower density. Okay, so that's why the density is okay. So that is very much small. So the reason behind this thing is to make the critical angle almost equal to zero. That's why in case of this, the critical angle is almost equal to zero. So rather than going in this zigzag manner or like this circular manner, the signal is going now in the straight way. Okay, almost straight way. So almost going in the horizontal direction. So that is known as the single mode. Okay. The fiber types are classified based on the ratio of core and cladding. So we can say that we have the fiber optic in which ratio is 50 divided by 125. That is, size of the core is 50 micrometer, size of cladding is 125 micrometer. So this type of the fiber is 50 divided by 125. So this is known as the multimode gridded index. Same way, ratio 62.5 divided by 125. That is also multimode gridded index. 100 divided by 125 and 70 divided by 125, that is the single mode. So you can see here that the density of the core is very much smaller than the cladding. Okay, how the fiber optics cables are made? So we can say that we have the outer jacket that is either made of PVC or Teflon. Okay, PVC ke Teflon nu bane lo hai. Then inside we have the DuPont Kevlar for strength. So aaj this is known as the Kevlar. Okay, so Kevlar nu aaj cover aave che, that is made of that material is, I think, શું કહેવાય, જે બુલેટ પ્રૂફ જેકેટમાં જે મટીરિયલ યુઝ થાય ધેટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધી કેવલર જેકેટ. ઓકે, સો ધી કેવલર જેકેટનું જે આ બીજું લેયર છે તે બનેલું હોય. એની અંદર વી હેવ ધી પ્લાસ્ટિક બફર. ઓકે, સો પ્લાસ્ટિક બફરથી કવર કરેલું હોય. અને ઇનસાઇડ વી હેવ ધી ગ્લાસ ઓર પ્લાસ્ટિક કોર, કોર અને ક્લિનિંગ. ઓકે, સો યુ કેન સે દેટ યોર ઓરિજિનલ ફાઈબર ઓપ્ટિક કેબલ ઇઝ કવર્ડ બાય ધી થ્રી થ્રી કવર્સ. વન ઇઝ ધી પ્લાસ્ટિક કવર, દેન વી હેવ ધી કેવલર, એન્ડ દેન ફાઇનલી વી હેવ ધી આઉટર જેકેટ. ધેર ઇઝ અ વેરી નેગ્લેજિબલ ઇફેક્ટ ઓફ ધી નોઇઝ. Various connectors used in the fiber optic cables are SC connector, ST connector and MT-RG connector. So generally these SC connectors are used in the cable TV, okay, while these ST connectors are used in the network communication, that is connection of the various devices in the network, while this MT-RG connector is like that RJ45 connector apde je twisted pair cable ma use karelu, the same way we have this MTRJ connectors. Okay, so the graph of wavelength versus loss. Okay, loss means attenuation. Okay, and wavelength is our in the nanometer. So result is very interesting. It is saying that we don't have sudden increase of this wavelength. We don't have a sudden increase of the attenuation in our signals. So we can say that our loss is almost constant. So there is no sudden increase, so we can say that we have the almost constant attenuation on different wavelength. Just wait a minute. Okay, so compared to the graph of wavelength to the loss, we can say that almost for every wavelength, like 800 to 160, 1600, we have the constant loss. That means we can say that almost constant attenuation. Not like that fiber, not like that twisted pair cable or that optical fiber cable. Okay, so we can say that here we have the constant values of the attenuation. The applications of fiber optic cable is in the backbone networks. Okay, જે રીતે દરિયાની અંદરથી જે મોટા મોટા કેબલ નાખીને જે આપણો ડેટા બીજી કન્ટ્રીમાંથી આપણી કન્ટ્રીમાં આવે, તો ફોર દેટ વી આર યુઝિંગ ધી ફાઈબર ઓપ્ટિક કેબલ. સો ઇટ ઇઝ જનરલી ફાઉન્ડ ઇન ધી બેકબોન નેટવર્ક. સો યુ કેન સર્ચ ઓન ધી ઇન્ટરનેટ, વન ગુડ વિડીયો ઇઝ ધેર દેટ હાઉ ઇન્ટરનેટ વર્ક્સ. Okay, so you can search on the YouTube that how internet works. You can see that motta motta cable dariya ni niche thi pass karela hoy ye country ma thi biji country ma thi apna data laavva mate. So this is known as our backbone network, through which our data comes from one country to the another country, and for that we are using this fiber optic cable. And it's because its wide bandwidth is cost effective, and today with compared to the twisted pair or the second cable, this fiber optic cables are somewhat costlier, but so that's why we are using this cable only in the backbone network. So today with WDM we can transfer the data at a rate of 1600 Gbps. Okay, so using the speed of 1600 Gbps we can transfer the data. So some cable TV companies use a combination of optical fiber and coaxial cable, thus creating a hybrid network. Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Okay, so the application of this fiber optic cable is, we can say, in the backbone network, and by some cable TV companies. Okay, there is a, most of the cable TV companies are combining the optical fiber with the coaxial cable, thus creating the hybrid networks. Okay, there is a There's some problem with this fiber optic cable is the higher cost. So that's why we cannot only use the fiber optic cable. We need to combine it with some other type of cables. Okay, so that's why these cable TV companies are creating the hybrid networks. The advantage of these fiber optic cables are higher bandwidth, then less signal attenuation, okay, compared to the another two types of cable, that is the coaxial and twisted pair cable. We can have a less signal attenuation. That means a signal can run for 50 kilometers without requiring the regeneration. And while in case of the coaxial or twisted pair cable, after every 5 kilometers, we require the repeaters. While in case of the fiber optic cable, 50 kilometers pachi apne repeater joise. Then immunity to electromagnetic interference, that means there is a less effect of the noise, resistant to corrosive materials. So glass is more resistant to corrosive materials than copper. Okay. Lightweight compared to the another two, the fiber optic cables are lightweight and greater immunity to tapping. So it is, we can say that it is covered by the three cover, so it is very less chance to tapping. But still we have some disadvantages. The first disadvantage is installation and maintenance. So its installation and maintenance requires expertise that is not yet available everywhere. So we require the expertise of fiber optic cable that can install and configure such type of cables. Unidirectional light propagation. That's why in case of the fiber optic cable, your light can go only in the one direction. So that's why send karva maate apanne ek cable joiye ane receive karva maate apanne bijo cable joiye. And the final disadvantage is cost. So it is more expensive than those of twisted pair and optical fibers. But we can say if the demand for bandwidth is not high, often the use of optical fiber cannot be justified. So like we can use such type of cables only for the backbone network in which we have the high requirement of the bandwidth. Okay, so but in some small type of LAN or Ethernet network, we can't use the fiber optic cable. The reason is the cost is very much high. Okay. Then the second category is unguided media, that means the wireless communication. So in case of the wireless communication, we can see that the air is working as a medium. So we can have electromagnetic spectrum that we have learned in the school also, that 3 kilohertz to 300 gigahertz are known as the radio wave or microwave. 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz is known as the infrared, and 400 terahertz to 900 terahertz are known as the light wave. So these three types of waves we are using in the unguided media. So we can have various types of propagation methods. It can be ground propagation, sky propagation, or line of sight propagation. So ground propagation, that is below 2 megahertz, in which your signals are propagated on the surface of the earth, and it is generally propagated in the ionosphere. Then we have the sky propagation, in which we have the two towers. The tower apro signal ne mokle ionosphere ma, ionosphere thi vadi pacho reflect thaine bija tower ne mare. While in case of the line of sight propagation, there are the two antennas that should be parallel. So that means we have the line of sight, pehla madhi je nikle, that is can go in the straight way to the second antenna. Various bands are there, VLF, very low frequency, that is used for the 3 to 30 kilohertz, and it is known as the ground propagation, and that is majorly used for the long range radio navigation. Okay, and various other frequencies are there, okay, so that you can follow from here. Then the wireless transmission can be radio wave, microwave, or infrared. In case of the radio wave, we are using the omnidirectional antenna, in which tumhare the mobile tower ma apne je use kariye chhe te, that means ke je signal tumaro nikle te, it will flow in the every direction, okay, but the direction ma broadcast thai. So such type of antennas are known as the omnidirectional antenna. So when an antenna transmit radio waves, they are propagated in all directions. So radio wave, particularly those waves that propagate in the sky mode, can travel the long distances. So for AM radio or FM radio, we are using the such type of radio waves. Okay. So radio waves are used for multicast communication such as radio and television and paging system. Then second types of waves are microwaves, in which we are using the unidirectional antenna. That can be two type, it can be dish antenna or it can be the horn antenna. So in case of the dish antenna, you can see here that our signals are sent to one parabola, and parabola can focus the all the signals on one of the point. So these are known as the dish antenna. But in case of the horn antenna, as the name suggests, the shape is like the horn, and from the one end we are transmitting the signal, and from the other way they can be transmitted. So microwaves are used for unicast communication such as the cellular, telephone, satellite networks and wireless LANs. Then we have the third, that is infrared signals can be used for short range communication in a closed area using line of sight propagation. So there apne bluetooth use kariye ke pachi pelu kayu se data transfer karva mate peli app che. Okay, so that for such type of application we can use the infrared communication, in which your data can be used for the short range communication. Same jyare apne remote thi TV ni channel badaliye, at that time also we are using the infrared signals. Okay. So this is all about the media. Okay, your medium can be wired or it can be wireless, guided or unguided. In case of the guided, we have the twisted pair cable, then we have the coaxial cable, and finally we have the optical fiber cable. In case of the unguided media, we have the microwave, infrared and radio waves. Radio wave, microwave and infrared. So we have seen all this. First we have started with the twisted pair cable, then we have learned twisted pair cable is majorly used in 10 base, that means the traditional TV network or the network with we can say the speed of 10 or 100 Mbps, in which we are using the twisted pair cables. The coaxial cables are majorly used for the TV communications, while the fiber optic cables are used as a backbone networks. Okay, and finally we have seen the unguided medium, in which we have the radio wave, then we have the microwave, and finally we have the infrared. So this is all about the physical layer. Okay, so in the last we have the some of the exercise. Okay, so I will provide you this exercise as a assignment. Okay, so that you have to submit, you need to write down the answer and you need to submit the book. Okay, so if you have any doubt in the exercise, you can ask at that time. Okay, so I will provide you this all type of assignment questions and you need to answer all. Okay, so this is all about the physical layer. The next module that we are starting is the data link layer, but before that, as the part of the continuous evaluation, okay, the quiz will be there. Okay, so as you have given the quiz of module number 1, same way you need to give a quiz of module number 2. Okay, so I have organized this quiz on Monday. Okay, that is kai tarikh aavse, Monday aavse apni tarikh 27. Okay, so 27 on the same time that we are used for the module 1, that 10:45. So Monday 10:45, you need to give a quiz of module number 2. Okay, and that 20 marks will be considered as your continuous evaluation component, and finally that can be considered for your 40 marks of your continuous evaluation. So that's why you need to read and you need to be careful while giving this quiz of module number 2. Okay, so just take the quick review of the physical layer. So physical layer is majorly responsible for transmission of signal from one system to another system. Then we can say that for that we require the signal. Signal can be either analog or digital signals. Analog signal has the continuous waves, while digital signal have some discrete value. Same way analog data are there, same way we have the signal can be either analog or digital signals. So this analog and digital signal both can be periodic or non-periodic. So periodic analog signals is like our sine waves, while the non-periodic digital signals in which we can say there is no repetition of cycles. To measure the periodic analog signal, we have the various criteria, that is the peak amplitude, and we have the period and frequency, and finally we have the phase values. Okay, there are the various units for the amplitude, frequency and periods. We have seen some of the examples. Then we have seen the phase values. So phase, we can say that the meaning of phase is the position of the waveform relative to the time zero. Okay, so the phase can be measured either in the degree or radians. Then we have seen the wavelength. Then to represent the analog signals, we have the various representation. We can have a time domain representation and we can have a frequency domain representation. In the time domain, we have the graph of frequency versus amplitude, while in case of the frequency domain representation, we have the graph of frequency versus amplitude. Then we have the bandwidth. Bandwidth, we can say that difference between the highest and lowest frequency, that is known as the bandwidth. This is all about analog signal. Then we have started with the digital signals. So digital signals in which we have the number of levels. If number of levels are 2, then we can say the value can be 0 or 1. The number of levels are 4, then we require the 4 discrete values, that is 00, 01, 10 and 11. So based on that, we can derive the formula that if the number of levels are n, then we require the number of bits per levels are log n base 2. Okay. Bit rate means the number of bit that you can send in seconds. Okay, so generally it is represented by BPS, but the other units are Mbps, Gbps or Tbps. We have seen some of the example. Then we have defined the bit length, means the distance that is occupied by one bit on the transmission medium, and the formula is propagation speed into the bit duration. Transmission impairment means whenever the signal is passing through the channel, there are some reasons through which the signals can be affected. So there are three reasons. One is attenuation, distortion and noise. Attenuation means loss of energy. And to measure the attenuation, we have the unit called decibel. And the formula of decibel is 10 log P2 by P1 base 10. P2 means the signal at the point number 2, and P1 means signal at the point number 1. Then we have the distortion. Distortion means the change in the shape of the signals. So we can say that the distortions are mainly due to the phase values at the different phase values at the receiving side. And finally, we have the noise. Noise means some extra signals are added with the original data. We can have different types of noise: thermal noise, induced noise, crosstalk, and impulse noise. To measure the noise, we have the signal to noise ratio. The formula is average signal power divided by the average noise power. And if you want to represent these values in the decimal, then you have the formula that SNR dB equal to 10 log SNR base 10. Okay. Then we have the data rate limit. So data rate limit means how fast you can send the data. These data rate limits are based on the three factors: bandwidth, level and quality. And to define this data rate, we have the two formulas. One is the Nyquist theorem and second one is the Shannon capacity. The Nyquist theorems are used for the noiseless channel, while the Shannon capacity are used for the noisy channels. For the noiseless channel, the Nyquist theorems are defined as 2 cross bandwidth cross log L base 2. So this is the formula for the noiseless channel. For the noisy channel, we have the Shannon capacity, and the formula is B log 1 plus SNR base 2. In the real time, we are using the combination of both. We can say that the Shannon capacity gives you the upper limit, while the Nyquist formula gives the number of levels. Then we have started with the transmission modes. That means in the medium, how you can send our data. Okay. That means at a time you can send only one bit or multiple bit. Based on that, we have decided the transmission mode. Transmission mode can be either single or transmission mode can be either serial or parallel. In parallel, multiple bits are sent, while in case of the serial, only one bit can be sent at a time. In case of the serial, we have the three types of communication: asynchronous, synchronous, and isosynchronous. Okay. We have started with the parallel, in which we can say that multiple lines are there through which the multiple bits can be sent at a time. In case of the serial, one bit at a time can be sent. So the serial transmission can be either asynchronous or synchronous or isosynchronous. In case of the asynchronous transmission, we are sending the data in form of the bytes. Okay, in which we require the start bit and stop bit. 0 indicate the start bit and 1 indicate the stop bit. While in case of the asynchronous transmission, we are sending the frame. So frame can be considered as a multiple bytes. And that is, in case of the asynchronous, the timing is not important, but in case of the synchronous, timing is very much important. And finally, we have seen the isosynchronous transmission, that is majorly used for the TV communication, in which the one TV image consists of the multiple pixel and multiple pixel consists of the multiple bits. In such type of case, we can say that there should be the whole image can be of one frame. Okay. Then we have started with the multiplexing, when the bandwidth of the link is shared among the multiple devices, so that is known as the multiplexing. So we can divide your link based on the three factors, that is frequency, wavelength, and time. So based on the frequency, we have the FDM, based on the wavelength, we have the WDM, and based on the time, we have the TDM. FDM and WDM majorly used for the analog signals, while TDM is majorly used for the digital signals. Okay. So we have seen the FDM, in which your signals, or we can say link, is divided based on the frequencies. And we have seen some of the example related to this, related to the FDM. Okay. Then we have the WDM, in which majorly it is used for the fiber optic cable, in which we are using the prism at the end to perform the multiplexing and demultiplexing. So WDM is majorly used for the high frequency signals. Then we have seen the TDM. So in case of the TDM, your link is shared based on the time. Okay, so you can say that your link is divided based on some time units, and each unit, your input and output slot both are divided based on some time units. So we have seen this example that in case of this input channel, three input channel, all three input channels are divided on T time units. And same way, we are creating the output frame. The output frame consists of the each input unit, and the duration of the each output unit is T by 3. So here we can see this example. If we have the three channel all with 1 Kbps, 1 Kbps, 1 Kbps, then we can get a speed that is 1/3 millisecond. Okay, so here the input time duration is 1 millisecond, then the output time duration is 1/3 millisecond, and the duration of the frame is 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3, so we can say that 1 millisecond. So TDM can be either synchronous TDM or it can be statistical TDM. So in case of the synchronous TDM, the data rate of the link is n time faster and the unit duration is n time shorter. So we have seen this example that if we have the 4 1 Kbps channels, so you can see that the input time slot duration is 1 millisecond, then the output data rate is 4 Kbps, while the duration of the output time slot is, if you have the 4 channels, then 1/4 millisecond, and the duration of frame is 1/4. So it is same as the duration of the input time slot, that is the 1 millisecond. In case of the synchronous TDM, there is a problem of idle time slot. Okay, so for that we are using the statistical TDM, in which the slots are allocated dynamically, but still we have the problem that at the receiving side we cannot distinguish between the one slot with the second slot. So for that we are adding the address with the each output time slot. So for example, A1 is coming from small a, B1 is coming from small b. The small a, b and d that are used as the identifier for each channels. And finally, we have seen the transmission medium. So it can be guided or unguided, in which we have the guided, we have the twisted pair, coaxial cable and fiber optic. And for the unguided, we have the radio wave, microwave and infrared. So this is all about the physical layers. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, still we have the time. So we can start with the module number 3, that is the data link layer. Okay. Can anyone say what is the responsibilities of the data link layer? Can anyone say what are the responsibilities of data link layer?
Hop to hop transaction.
Hop to hop delivery. Good, very good. Then. Anyone else?
MAC address.
Okay, addressing.
That is MAC address add karna.
MAC address add karse. Then. Biju bhai. Okay, so first we'll start with the data link layer. Kya avelu chhe? To data link layer avelu chhe avdu physical layer ni upar ane network layer ni niche. તો નેટવર્ક લેયર થી ડેટા એસેપ્ટ કરે અને ફિઝિકલ લેયર ને મોકલાવે. ઓકે, વોટ ઇઝ ધ યુનિટ એટ ધ ડેટા લિંક લેયર? ડેટા લિંક લેયર પર ડેટા કયા ફોર્મ માં હોય આપણો ડેટા? ફિઝિકલ લેયર પર એ બીટ ના ફોર્મ માં હોય, નેટવર્ક લેયર પર એ પેકેટ ના ફોર્મ માં હોય. તો ડેટા લિંક લેયર પર કયા ફોર્મ માં હશે?
ફ્રેમ્સ.
ફ્રેમ્સ ના ફોર્મ માં. ઓકે, સો ધ ટાસ્ક ઓફ ધીસ ડેટા લિંક લેયર ઇઝ નેટવર્ક લેયર પરથી પેકેટ મંગાવશે. ઓકે, પેકેટ ની અંદર ઇટ વિલ એન્કેપ્સ્યુલેટ. ઓકે, એન્કેપ્સ્યુલેટ મતલબ કે મેક એડ્રેસ ને એડ કરશે અને મેક એડ્રેસ સેટ થઈ જાય પછી ઇટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધી ફ્રેમ. ઓકે, સો ધેટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધી એન્કેપ્સ્યુલેશન ઓફ મેક એડ્રેસ ઇન ધી પેકેટ. સો એઝ યુ હેવ સેડ ધેટ ઇટ ઇઝ મેજરલી રિસ્પોન્સિબલ ફોર હોપ ટુ હોપ ડિલિવરી. સો વોટ ઇઝ મીનિંગ ઓફ હોપ ટુ હોપ ડિલિવરી? સો ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, સપોઝ તમારે ગૂગલ પરથી કંઈ સર્ચ કરવું હોય, ઓકે, સો એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ યુ કેન નોટ ડાયરેક્ટલી સેન્ડ અવર રિક્વેસ્ટ ટુ ધી ગૂગલ સર્વર, બટ આપણી રિક્વેસ્ટ છે તે ઇન્ટરમિડિયેટ રાઉટર પરથી પાસ થઈ જાય. સો અવર રિક્વેસ્ટ ઇઝ પાસ થ્રુ ધી ઇન્ટરમિડિયેટ રાઉટર્સ and finally it will reach to the Google server. Okay, so majorly this data link layer is responsible for hop to hop delivery. So that means ke tamara PC mathi pehli request jase default router par, so for that you require the MAC address of default router. Okay, so that task can be performed by the data link layer. Then default router par thi jase tamari request, let's say router number 1 par, so that is known as such type of deliveries are known as the hop to hop delivery. Okay, so for that we require the encapsulation and decapsulation. What is the meaning of encapsulation and decapsulation? So for example, let's say tomorrow friend koi biji city ma rahe che, okay, if you are staying in Surat, tomorrow friend rahe che Ahmedabad ma, okay, now tame tamara friend na ghare Ahmedabad malva mate jao che, so what first thing you will do, so let's assume that tame jai raha chho train ma, okay, to pehla to tame ghare taxi bolave, okay, so ghare taxi bolave pachi taxi ma tame enter thai, so that is known as the encapsulation, okay. Now ટેક્સી લઈને તમે ક્યાં પહોંચશે, તો ટેક્સી લઈને તમે પહોંચશે રેલવે સ્ટેશન, અને ત્યાંથી તમે ટેક્સીમાંથી ઉતરી જાઓ, ધેટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધ ડીકેપ્સ્યુલેશન, ઓકે, તો મેક એડ્રેસ સેટ થયું, ઓકે, અને મેક એડ્રેસ રિમૂવ થયું, ઓકે, નાવ ફરી પાછું રેલવે સ્ટેશન પર શું થશે, તો તમે ટેક્સીમાંથી ઉતરીને ટ્રેનમાં એન્ટર થાવ છો, તો ધેટ ઇઝ જે ઇન્ટરમિડિયેટ આપણું જે સ્ટેશન છે ત્યાં બંને વસ્તુ પરફોર્મ થાય, ડીકેપ્સ્યુલેશન મતલબ તમે ટેક્સીમાંથી ઉતરો છો, અને એન્કેપ્સ્યુલેશન મતલબ ટ્રેનમાં એન્ટર થાવ છો, ઓકે. નાવ ટ્રેનમાંથી બેસીને તમે પહોંચો છો અમદાવાદના રેલવે સ્ટેશન પર, ઓકે, તો અમદાવાદના રેલવે સ્ટેશન પર પણ બંને વસ્તુ પરફોર્મ થશે, તમે ટ્રેનમાંથી ઉતરશો અને ત્યાંની જે ટેક્સી કરી હશે તમે ટેક્સીમાં એન્ટર થશો, ઓકે. સો ફાઇનલી ટેક્સી લઈને તમે તમારા ફ્રેન્ડના ઘરે પહોંચો છો, તમારા ફ્રેન્ડના ઘરે તમે ટેક્સીમાંથી ઉતરો છો, તો ત્યાં થશે ખાલી ડીકેપ્સ્યુલેશન, ઓકે. સો યુ કેન સે દેટ when you are going through the intermediate nodes, okay, tame standing side you are performing only encapsulation, ke khali tame gaadi ma enter thao chho, okay, taxi ma enter thao chho, while at the receiving side you are performing only the decapsulation, એટલે ખાલી તમે ટેક્સીમાંથી ઉતરો છો, okay, while in case of the intermediate all nodes like Surat railway station par ane Ahmedabad railway station par tame banne vastu perform karo chho, ke ગાડીમાંથી ટેક્સીમાંથી ઉતરો છો અને ટ્રેનમાં ચડો છો, અને ટ્રેનમાંથી ઉતરો છો અને અમદાવાદ રેલવે સ્ટેશન પર ટ્રેનમાંથી ઉતરો છો અને ટેક્સીમાં એન્ટર થાવ છો, તો મતલબ ઇન્ટરમિડિયેટ જેટલા બી નોડ છે ત્યાં બંને વસ્તુ થશે, એન્કેપ્સ્યુલેશન અને ડીકેપ્સ્યુલેશન, ઓકે. સો સેમ થિંગ ઇઝ હેપન્ડ વેન યુ આર સેન્ડિંગ ધી ડેટા ટુ ધી રિમોટ મશીન, તમે તમારો ડેટા સપોઝ ગૂગલ સર્વરને મોકલાવો છો, ઓકે, એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ વી કેન સે દેટ બોથ થિંગ્સ આર ગોઈંગ ટુ બી પરફોર્મ, ઓકે, સો એટ ધી સેન્ડિંગ સાઇડ તમારો ડેટા જનરેટ થાય, એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ યુ આર એડિંગ ધી યુ કેન સે દેટ યુ આર એડિંગ ધી મેક એડ્રેસ ઓફ ધી નેક્સ્ટ હોપ, દેટ મીન્સ યુ આર પરફોર્મિંગ ધી એન્કેપ્સ્યુલેશન, ઓકે. નાવ તમારો ડેટા જ્યારે પહેલા રહો, ઇફ યુ એઝ્યુમ દેટ you and Google server, okay, tamara machine and Google server ni vache bear router che R1 ane R2, okay, now tamaro data je tamara machine thi nikle che, at that time you are adding the MAC address of router 1, okay, so e MAC address add karva mate we have the one protocol ERP, je apne lab ma joyu che ke how ERP are going to be work, okay, so by using this ERP protocol we will find the MAC address of router 1, અને રાઉટર 1 નું મેક એડ્રેસ મળી ગયું, તો આપણે પેકેટ ની અંદર રાઉટર 1 નું મેક એડ્રેસ એડ કરી દઈએ, અને પછી આપણો ડેટા સેન્ડ થાય રાઉટર 1 ને, ઓકે. રાઉટર 1 પર ડેટા આવી ગયો, ત્યાં બંને વસ્તુ પરફોર્મ થશે, કે રાઉટર 1 માં જે મેક એડ્રેસ એડ કરેલું હતું રાઉટર 1 નું, તો પોતાનું મેક એડ્રેસ રિમૂવ કરશે, અને સેમ મેથડ જે ERP ની મેથડ થી રાઉટર 2 નું મેક એડ્રેસ ફાઇન્ડ કરશે, ઓકે. તો રાઉટર 1 પર બે વસ્તુ પરફોર્મ થાય, પોતાનું મેક એડ્રેસ રિમૂવ થાય, અને એની જગ્યાએ રાઉટર 2 નું મેક એડ્રેસ એડ થાય, ઓકે, અને ફરી પાછો એ ડેટા મોકલાવે રાઉટર 2 ને. રાઉટર 2 પર બંને વસ્તુ પરફોર્મ થાય, પોતાનું મેક એડ્રેસ રિમૂવ થશે અને જે આપણું ડેસ્ટિનેશન છે એનું મેક એડ્રેસ એડ થશે, ધેટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધી હોપ ટુ હોપ ડિલિવરી. અને એકવાર ડેસ્ટિનેશન પર ડેટા પહોંચી ગયો, તો ડેસ્ટિનેશન છે એ પોતાનું મેક એડ્રેસ રિમૂવ કરશે, જે અપર લેયર છે એને ડેટા એ પ્રોવાઈડ કરશે, ઓકે. સો ધીસ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધી હોપ ટુ હોપ ડિલિવરી. તો પહેલા આપણો ડેટા જશે રાઉટર 1 પર, ત્યાંથી રાઉટર 2 પર, અને ફાઇનલી આપણો ડેટા જશે ડેસ્ટિનેશન પર, ઓકે. સો આ હોપ ટુ હોપ ડિલિવરી માટે વી આર યુઝિંગ ધી મેક એડ્રેસ, ઓકે, એન્ડ ધેટ ઇઝ ટાસ્ક ઇઝ પરફોર્મ બાય ધી ડેટા લિંક લેયર, એના માટે જે પ્રોટોકોલ યુઝ કરીએ છીએ ધેટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ધી ERP, ઓકે. ધીસ ઇઝ ઓલ અબાઉટ સમ ઇન્ટ્રોડક્શન ઓફ ધી ડેટા લિંક લેયર, ઓકે. વી વિલ બિગિન વિથ ધીસ થિંગ ઇન ધી નેક્સ્ટ લેક્ચર.